Hi guys. All right, I'm on my way to work and I just pulled over to the side here. Hourly Watch had posted something as while I was looking up, or the last 2 days. Yesterday I went to Walmart and noticed my store shelves here in Michigan are running, stock is low, you know, and I had seen little videos, you know, of other people posting them on YouTube, so that just kind of confirmed something to me. And then he led me to, which was weird because I read Luke 17 this morning and I was just going to use that anyways, but just to even shorten it up, he wanted me to read Luke 17:26, and it said, just as in the days of Noah, so also will be in the days of the Son of Man. People were eating, drinking, marrying, and being given in marriage up to the day Noah entered the ark. Then the flood came and destroyed them all. It was the same in the days of Lot. People were eating and drinking, buying and selling, planting and building. But the day Lot left Sodom, fire and sulfur rained down from heaven and destroyed them all. So the conclusion I had from this is if we are low on food right now, and you know, the things that we've picked up from our videos, being watchful, you know, that's gonna spread like wildfire, right? Like in 2 weeks the store shelves will probably be more empty. And if they're empty, then that means people can't be eating and drinking, right? I mean, sure, they're not going to be totally empty. It's not like we're going to be starved. And for us that trust in Christ, we know our Lord will provide. But if we logically look at it, how can people have a wedding if they don't have wedding food? So if when the Lord comes, people are eating and drinking and getting married, I feel like we have a small window. And, you know, the Lord could change this. We could get shipments in and fill our shelves back up, perhaps. But there's something that's really strange about it that I just don't know, you know, if this makes sense to you guys. And I guess just keep up on each other's stores. Pay attention to your food. And, you know, you don't have to totally stock up. But maybe, if you're able, I would, you know, instead of buying a new shirt, buying new jeans, buying anything that really means, is not going to mean that much, I would recommend you buy food, you know? And I had sent a couple of my close friends that, you know, are not totally believers, you know, some pictures of the shelves and just told them, you know, if they're able to stock up, you know, because I love them. You know, they might not understand why I say this, and I actually got a message back that said, why are you saying this? That's just your store. This isn't the end, because they know that I preach the rapture, you know. And with that, you know, I hope we realize how truly blessed we are, and that we have a duty and a task that the Lord has given us. And when I say this, it's almost like he, you know, we are able to see into the future a little bit, you know, respectfully listening to our brothers and sisters and what they say and collaborating on things. And just having fun noticing how close our Lord really is, you know. You know, we've gone through hard times and we've learned to armor up, and my point is just, we've got to be so close. And I just, keep your eyes open on this one, you know, because people can't have a wedding if they don't have wedding food, you know, and the Lord says he'll come when people are getting married. And if, I don't know, he's just kind of, you know, now when it comes to people mocking me, I don't really respond unless the Lord leads me to. because I know I can kind of just stand back and the Lord is going to do what he does. Meaning, you know, for my friends that don't think this is the end and think we're going to have an abundance of food forever, they're not logically, they haven't been watching like us. They haven't been paying attention to, you know, the natural disasters and the fires that have destroyed lots of things and the wars that are going on and the prices that are increasing and in trade, you know. I know that we're out of glass. You know, I went to my local bar only because that's all we got in my little town. We have a bar and a party store and a church and a fire station. That's it. Or maybe a couple more buildings, but I asked my bar, I said, how you guys doing on stock, you know, and they said they're out of a lot of things. So ask your neighbors, ask them what's going on with the stock, you know, just pay attention. You know, the Lord says, be watchful, be on guard. And, you know, our faith has increased. And it's a blessing because of all of us knowing the same Jesus, and he's been so faithful within this year, and oh, we have spiritual eyes to see, you know, and a duty and a mission to finish before the rapture. So ask the Lord to strengthen you so that you can keep on finishing, you know. And if you've never made a video, ask the Lord to help you, just like Isaiah that said, here I am, Lord, use me, you know. Or, you know, I'm just really grateful. I'm not scared. I mean, we've been through this, we've been touching the fire a couple times now this year. And every time the Lord has taken care of us in different ways, you know, through prayer. And I really want to have the ability to smile for those who are suffering and try to be happy and fun and let people know you can be silly when you're feeling it in the spirit. You can be happy, you know. I love the thought of lifting up, you know, a fellow sister or brother or teenagers, you know, that are just learning. So I ask the Lord, you know, please don't let me be depressed through all this, and don't let me be mean, you know, like frustrated. But just let me be patient, and Lord, let me approach situations just like you would, Jesus, you know. I too deal with things in my house, you know. My poor son, he woke up today and he gets pretty mouthy with his mama, and I have to you know, just pray and all sorts of things I'm doing when he's doing that. But you know, I also, he's 14, and so this morning I kind of just took a walk in my woods, and he called me on my phone, and I told him, I said, hey, bud, you're a young man now, you know, you're going to have to figure this out on your own, you know, and not be cranky about it, you know, and if you're just coming to the understanding and learning about the rapture because of the finished work of the cross, and things like that, I just ask you, just please, just listen to brothers and sisters. You don't have to say anything. Just listen, and over time, put all the puzzle pieces together. You know, it's a lot of fun. And know that his promises are true. And just like Elisha, you know, asked Elijah for a double portion of faith, you know, ask the Lord for faith. The disciples asked for faith to be increased. And when the Lord comes, he's looking for faith on the earth, you know. Learn about the wedding parable. Oh, you know, for the last year we have, you know, we told our brothers and sisters in Christ, or, you know, that claim to be Christians, and some of them didn't believe us, so the Lord told us to go out into the alleys, into the corners of the earth, and invite people that will just listen, you know, and many have come, and many have joined the discords and jumped on board the ark, and they too have seen it, you know, Just another sliver that I learned about in the beginning that I've kind of tucked away in my pocket, I suppose. You know, I learned about the new moon and in Jerusalem during Rosh Hashanah when they see the new moon that they blow the trumpets, you know, that's what they do. And this year, September, you know, I'm not making any day, but it's just kind of interesting that Labor Day falls on right before Rosh Hashanah, which is the day of the Feast of Trumpets. And we know that these are like birth pains and you know, they give labor, you know. I'm just kind of giving you like the cliff notes of the Bible. But most importantly, always seek the Lord every morning. Every morning. I've been doing it now for, it's just come so natural. I'm not tired in the morning. I wake up, I grab a cup of coffee, and I open the Bible, and I tell the Lord I'm seeking Him. And I've done this now for 2 years, and I did it before, but the last 2 years has just been such a joy to start my morning off, you know. I just read somewhere in the Bible, maybe Acts, where it said that, you know, where they would go to the temple in the morning and learn from Jesus. And so, you know, I don't know, there's just something special about those morning times, you know, and then pray without ceasing. But before I go on and on, you know, just put two and two together. Keep an eye on the food shortages, you know. I know the Lord will bless certain people that pray for food. That's what He does, you know. He feeds those that call upon His name. He will provide, you know. But just keep an eye out, you know. And if you're getting nervous, you know, ask for the Lord's peace. He gives peace. He is the Prince of Peace, you know. So there's other ways to go about these things. It's not fear-mongering. It's the Lord. I'm not fearful. I haven't really been that fearful all year long. I've been more excited than anything. And it's a joy to pray for people, you know, to pray for those in Afghanistan and realize that, oh, gosh, I just, you know, we have so much we need to be grateful and praise our Lord. And you know, so many people are walking around, I feel like, with a mirror in front of their face, only looking at themselves and their own successes and their future and them, when the Lord wants us to have compassion on the world. And to, through doing that, teach us His heart to love not only ourselves, you know. And that's the beautiful thing about our God, you know. We will give the, you know, the shirt off our back or the last couple cans in our cupboard to somebody else in Jesus' name, knowing that Jesus will provide for us, but hopefully they saw Jesus through us, you know. So yeah, I guess I can't wait to see what you all have to put on there today, but I truly feel like, you know, we're in a 2-week window when it comes to food shortages. You know, I looked up a couple more videos of other people posting, and then in my comments, they said, oh, it's the same here in South Carolina. Our shelves are getting low. I mean, how long can that last, guys? You know, not very long. I mean, thankfully, it's harvest season, and gardens are growing, so we will have those vegetables. But logically, I don't know, while people are worried about their looks and their things, they are not paying attention to the food shortages and what do you really need to live? Well, you need the bread of life, which is all you need to live. But you need food, you know, you need food and water. You don't need a cool Nike hoodie, you know, or whatever. I'm not against those things. I got teenagers, you know, and the Lord blesses us with those, but just don't be so focused on that, you know. Pay attention to the things that really, really, really matter. And then if you're doubting or you need to research, just research it. Like, for instance, I thought, after I sent those pictures about the shelves being empty in my town, I thought. And then, so I thought, well, maybe I'm wrong, you know. But then, sure enough, I looked up food shortages on the Google, and it talked about it. And then I looked up food shortages on the YouTube, and there's a couple different ladies and a man talking about how the shelves are empty, you know, or getting empty in their town. Now, this isn't all over. Hourly Watch said California's just fine, which is amazing with all the fires, you know. God bless them, though. So I guess just pray for food beforehand. Be grateful for your food. Try to get things that are healthy, more or less. Things that will stretch a long way, like spaghetti. And anyways, all right, I gotta work. I love you guys. Hang in there. Keep spreading your daily bread so that we all know what is going on. And be kind to each other. You know, we're all equal in the kingdom of God. Nobody's better than anybody else, you know. And just try to take the time to be compassionate and notice if a brother or sister or an unbeliever is suffering, and let them know you care when you can, you know. Always be kind. And if things get too heated in your home, it's okay to walk away and spend time with the Lord and let them calm down. I just say this because I've been dealing with it in my own house. And just asking the Lord, how do I fix this, Lord? Because I, you know, a lot of the times I say, Lord, I can't fix this, but you can. And then I wait upon him, you know. So just hang in there. You have a good day. Let's see what's on the radio. Worship.